to sleep. It's after 3 o'clock in the morning.
Annie, read me your note.
Again.
Father left the note saying that they were coming back.
That was 1922. This is 1933. Get up. Now for this one, shenanigans, you'll all get down on your knobby little knees and clean this dump until it shines at the top of the Chrysler Building.
But it's 4 o'clock in the morning.
Get to work.
Yes, Miss Hannigan.
Now, why any kid would want to be an orphan, I'll never know.
Yeah.
dynamite.
Gee, thanks, mister.
Say, kid, when is the orphan stepping?
As soon as I take a right.
Say, do you see any spray mugs around here?
No, sir.
Muscle's coming back to the hospital.
Hey, there's one they didn't get. They're after you, ain't they? Well, that me too. Don't worry, I ain't gonna let them get you for it.
The time, the time.
poor pumpkin, all out in the freezing cold, just that thin sweater. Hope you didn't catch influenza. Thank you so much, Dean Officer.
All the line of cute. And you, don't let me ever hear if they run away from this nice lady again.
The next time you walk out that door, it'll be 1953. Well, are you glad to be back, huh?
Yes, Miss Hannigan.
Liar, what's the one thing I always taught you? Never tell a lie.
Good afternoon, Miss Hannigan.
Yes.
I'm Grace Farrell, private secretary of Oliver Warbucks.
The Oliver Warbucks, the millionaire.
Mr. Warbucks has decided to invite an orphan to his house over the holidays.
What sort of orphan did he have in mind?
She should be friendly. And intelligent.
Mississippi, capital MISSISSIPPI. You shut up. And how old?
Oh, age doesn't really matter. Say 8 or 9, 10, 11. Yes, 11 would be perfect. And I almost forgot. Mr. Warbucks prefers red-headed children.
11, a redhead? Sorry, we don't have any woman like that here.
Shut this woman right here.
Annie, you don't want her.
What do you say, Annie? How'd you like to spend the next 2 weeks at Mr. Warbucks' house?
Gee, I'd love to. You can have any orphan here, but not Annie.
Well, maybe I'll just call the board of orphans.
If it's Annie you want, it's Annie you'll hear.
Annie, I want.
Gigi, I can hardly believe it.
Let's go get her coat, we'll be on our way.
She don't have no coat.
Well, then we'll buy her one.
Oh boy, I can hardly believe it.
Come on, Annie, Mr. Warbucks' limousine is outside.
She can hardly believe it.
Annie, bye, Annie. You lucky duck.
Hey, kids, I'm getting out here for Christmas. I'll write ya.
Bye.
Someday I'll land up. Get me now, so we can't, 'cause someone catch me.
Yeah. don't.
Once again, we bring you the romance from Helen Trent, who sets out to prove just because a woman is 35 or more, romance in life need not be over.
God, I hope not.
Right.
I'll give it to Annie and tell her that I want to adopt her. She's going to be the happiest little girl in the world. Get her down here.
Yes, sir.
Hi, Annie. Can we have a man-to-man talk?
You said you went to the orphanage, right?
No, of course not. Listen, Annie, I was born into a very poor family, and both of my parents died before I was 10. But I made a promise to myself. Someday, somehow, I was going to be rich. Very rich.
That was a good idea.
Yes, maybe it was. But lately I've realized something. No matter how rich you are, if you've got nobody to share it with, you might as well be broke. I was at Tiffany's yesterday.
Gee, thanks, Mr. Werbeck.
Wow. It's a silver locket. Annie, when I first saw you and I saw that old broken locket you always wear around your neck, I said to myself, I'm going to give that kid a nice new locket. Here, we'll just take this old one off.
No, I don't want a new one.
What's wrong, Annie?
You see, this locket. My parents left it for me when I was at the orphanage. And a note too. And see, the one thing I always wanted, the one thing in this whole world, is to just be like regular kids, with folks of my own.
It'll be okay. We'll find them. We'll find your parents for you.
Mr. Warbucks will find your mother and father, even if he has to put everyone in the organization on the job, even if he has to pull every political string there is to pull.
Up to and including the White House. Annie, give me your locket.
Well, Mr. Warbucks.
I understand, but it could be our best clue. We'll have the FBI trace it and figure out who bought it.
Okay. And maybe they should have my note too.
It's all right, Annie. You could be meeting your parents within a matter of days.
Really?
Really.
Oh, gee, I gotta write a letter to the kids about this.
Thank you, Bert.
Well, I can see by the old clock on the wall,
another of our Thursday night get-togethers. The fact that you can say after. Yes, this is your old softie. This is Healy Boy. Bert saying, until next week, same time, same station, good night.
Has located the manufacturer of Andy's locket in Utica, New York.
Oh, boy. boy!
Over 90,000 were made and sold. I'm sorry, Annie. I don't think the FBI thinks that there's a chance in a million of facing your transfer locker. I'm so sorry.
That's okay. You did too bad. I guess you can get along without folks. You didn't turn out so bad.
Grace?
Yes, sir?
Do you have those legal papers I handed you the other day?
Right here.
Annie, I want to adopt you.
Adopt me?
Yes or no?
Yes.
Great. This isn't just going to be an adoption. It's going to be a celebration. And you can have anyone in the world who wants to come to it. Who would you like?
I guess this Belle. Drake. This is you. And, well, everybody here.
Drake?
Oh, sure.
Tell the staff to get spiffed up. They're going to be guests at Annie's adoption party.
Yes, sir.
Anyone else?
Oh, and the kids.
Oh, I'm sorry, Annie. It'll be way past their bedtime now. But listen, how about this? We'll invite everybody from the orphanage over tomorrow for a big Christmas party.
Miss Hannigan, too.
Why not? Annie, I'm the luckiest man in the world.
I'm the luckiest kid. Together at last, together forever, we're tying a knot that never can sever. I don't need sunshine now, turn my skies to blue. I don't need anything but you. Just the day I'm playing awful.
You can say that again.
Just the day I'm playing awful.
Richer than Midas, but nothing on earth could ever divide us. And if tomorrow an apple seller too, I don't need anything, anything.
Thank you. Thinking about tomorrow, put away the cobwebs and the sorrow, till there's no Here comes Jordan Oliver, one of the orphans in Hard Knocks Life.
Come on in.
Jordan Oliver, let me ask you something.
No, I don't live
here. How do you like being in this show?
Good.
Okay, what's good about it?
Huh?
What's good about it?
The NYC and the Hard Knocks Life part.
Yeah, my favorites too.